Okay, students, this is the second video for merchandise inventory costing. I decided to start with the periodic system so that I could show you the formula that we use in periodic to calculate the cost of merchandise sold and the ending inventory. But we can also use it for perpetual to test our inventory that we have in our accounting records. The formula that I wanted to show you starts with beginning inventory plus purchases, and that's going to give you merchandise available for sale. Then you count your inventory, take a fiscal count, subtract your ending inventory, and then you can come up with your cost of merchandise sold. If you are testing your perpetual system, you can switch these around because you're probably going to know what your cost of merchandise sold is. So you can say beginning inventory plus purchases equals merchandise available for sale less cost of merchandise sold equals ending inventory. You can flip it around like that. Okay, we know what we have beginning inventory, and we know the number of units, and we should have a beginning unit cost that will give our total cost. And then as we make the purchases, we put in the units, the unit cost, and the total cost in the order that they were purchased. So what we have here is merchandise available for sale in units and in dollars. But what we don't know is how much of this dollar amount goes to ending inventory and goes to cost of merchandise sold. Because as you can see, your inventory cost varied from time to time. So that's what we're going to do now using the FIFO, first in, first out, cost flow assumption. We're going to come up with a cost of a value of our ending inventory and a cost of merchandise sold. Okay? All right. In the textbook, I'm using actually exercise 7.13, and then in that exercise, it tells us that we have an ending inventory number of units of 48. So we know that if we had 150 to start with, and we've have 48 left, and we've sold 102. So what we want to account for when we come up with the value of our ending inventory is 48 units. Now, if we're using FIFO, FIFO assumes that the first items that came in are the first items that are sold. So these items up here are gone, okay? If the problem asks you to look for ending inventory or to value ending inventory under a periodic system, basically, you're going to be looking at the bottom because these items are gone. If you're valuing ending inventory, you're going to be looking at the bottom. Occasionally, you'll get a problem that will ask you to value the cost of merchandise sold under FIFO, and if that's the case, you would look at the top because these are the items that are sold. But most problems will say, what is the ending inventory? Because it's easier to count the physical inventory, get the number of units, and then come up with the value of physical inventory, and then calculate the cost of merchandise sold, rather than actually calculate the cost of merchandise sold going through this process. Okay, we have 48 units to account for, so we're going to be looking at ending inventory under FIFO. We're going to start at the bottom, so that's 30 units times 840. Or 25,200. So that layer we've used now. So we go to the next layer because we've got 48 units to account for, so we need 18 more to get up to 48. Okay? Those 18 units will be costed out at 816. Now I'm going to use a cheat sheet here, so I won't have to calculate this. That's 14,688. And then what you're going to do is add those two together, and that is 39,888 for the actual value of your ending inventory, the 48 units under the FIFO method. Then all we have to do is subtract out the 39,888 in our formula to come up with the cost of the merchandise sold, which is 77,112. Okay? So that's how you would come up with your ending inventory and your cost of merchandise sold using FIFO. Now let's look at LIFO. Let's see if I have room here to put LIFO in. Okay? Now LIFO assumes that the first items that Actually, it's the last item, isn't it? LIFO assumes that the last items that come in are the first items that you sell. So what you have left in ending inventory now are the first units, okay? So LIFO assumes that the last items that come in are the first items that are sold. So therefore, if you're looking for ending inventory, you're going to go to the top. We have 48 to account for, so we're going to look at the 42 units in the top. That's at a cost of $720 or $30,240. Now, how many more do we have to account for? Well, we need to account for 48. We've accounted for 42, so we need 6. That would make our 48. And that would be coming down. That would be at $780. All right, let me use my cheat sheet here. 6 at $780 would be $4,680 for a total of $34,920. Now, I'm going to go over here and erase this out now because now we're going to put it in for LIFO, and I don't have room to put both on the board here. So we're going to put in the 34 minus the $34,920. So our cost of merchandise sold under LIFO is $82,000. Let me get a better 8 there. $82,080. Okay. So that's how you would calculate your ending inventory and cost of merchandise sold under LIFO down here, and then here are your two amounts. All right, now the other method is an average. So I am going to erase the FIFO and LIFO here. You can always go back on the video if you need to look at it because I need the space to come up with the average. Erase this also. Okay, that doesn't erase too well, but I can clean it later. Okay, now what we're going to do to get the weighted average for the periodic system is to take the total cost in dollars, which is $117,000, and divide it by the total units, total available in units. So our average cost is $780. I had to look for it on the page there. All right, so $117,000 divided by $150 is $780. So now it's just a simple calculation to determine the value of ending inventory. Ending inventory then, we have 48 units. So 48 times $780 equals $37,440. You also could come up with cost of merchandise sold real easily because you know 102 units were sold times 780, and that would give you cost of merchandise sold of $79,560. You could also use your formula, plugging in the less $37,440 to get your $79,560. That's just a way to test it there. Okay, so we've gone over the periodic calculation of ending inventory and cost of merchandise sold using the LIFO, FIFO, and weighted average. Those are the three cost flow assumptions that you would use. Unless, of course, you're using specific identification. Okay, in the next video, we'll talk about the perpetual inventory system.